Hi everyone, Randy Swaty here, hoping to get you started with modifying a LANDFIRE biophysical settings model in a way that better represents current conditions. In this series of five videos, we will work through our trusty sage stump model. In this, the first video, we will learn how to organize our work and change one disturbance in one state class. While we are focused on the sage stump and introducing transitions you might not have on your landscape, these basic modeling tasks will apply to almost all modeling effort. Let us imagine that the fire regime of one state class has changed. Perhaps people have started camping in the shrub savanna state, leading to a substantial increase in a replacement fire in that class. In our fictional example, the annual probability has gone from 0.0062, or a 161-year reference fire return interval, to 0.1 for the 10-year current fire return interval. How do we model this? We go through the following steps. First, we run the reference condition model for baseline. Make sure you have a library with the sage stump biophysical setting loaded. Check the run control by double-clicking on the scenario, hitting the run control tab, and then make sure that the total iterations is set at 3 and that we have a start time step of 0 and an end time step of 1000. On the initial conditions tab, you will type 1000 into the total acres if needed and 1000 into the number of simulation cells if needed so that we get a cell size of 1 acre. Okay. This all looks good, so I will close this box, make sure my reference condition model scenario is highlighted, then I will hit run. And I will say yes to the library being saved. Okay, it looks like we have a successful run based on this green check mark in our run monitor. We'll close out of this and check to see if we do indeed have some results. I'm going to double-click on the succession classes chart in the bottom left-hand corner of my screen, and I will get a chart that represents the proportion of the state classes on the landscape. What I want you to notice is that your chart may look different. You may have a line chart selected. You will want to change that to column chart and hit apply, and you may have many more bars. What I've done to fix that is I've gone into this Include Data For dropdown and selected only the state classes within my model. We'll give you a moment to do that, and then we'll start making our new scenario. Before you do any modeling or adding in new information, you'll need to organize your work. Here, we will be keeping things simple, dealing with one strata, a biophysical setting for us, and apply one change per new scenario. As you advance, you may want to have multiple biophysical settings per project and make multiple changes per scenario. Got it? I think it will quickly become clear. So what we're going to do is right-click on our reference condition model scenario, copy that, then right-click on definitions and paste. We'll get a copy. Great. So we need to rename this. And we'll do that by right-clicking, hitting rename, and then I'm going to call this Changed Fire in Shrub Savanna Class, something like that. Hit OK. I'm going to double-click this scenario to open it, and I will need to add in a description. You'll want to make sure that you document as well, so that you don't get lost in the future. Okay, we also need to make sure that this read-only box is not checked. Mine isn't. I'm in good shape. Next, we'll go to Transition Pathways. I'm going to maximize this screen, or I'll go to Window, Arrange All, and everything's fitted together. Next, I'm going to zoom in a bit just to make this a little easier to see. Double-click on the state where you need to make the change. In the model, this is the mid-1 open state. We'll see that there are two replacement fire disturbances. I'll show you quickly. We can sort by double clicking on the column header. We want to change the replacement fire transition that goes from mid one open to early one open. To change the probability, we simply click on the cell and type in our new probability. Hit enter and it's set. We can close this pane, also closing out of the scenario pane, highlighting our scenario, then hitting run and saving. Okay, it looks like our new scenario has run successfully. Let's see what we have in our results. Ah, great. We do have a new chart with new proportions of the landscape for each state class. Sort of as expected, we have more early one all because of that increase in replacement fire in the mid one open class. We hope you've enjoyed this video and will join us soon for video 2, changing the probability of a disturbance across all state classes.